Praise the Lord, hallelujah. I hear the chains falling.
Behold, he comes riding on a cloud.
Praise the Lord. This is Choice Gospel Radio. You're listening to Salvation and Revelation. Jesus Christ is Lord. And today, even as we come before the throne room of grace, we just want to say thank God for another time. This is Evangelist Jennifer Pope. And even on this evening, no matter what you're going through, no matter what is your situation, God wants to break every chain. He wants to lift you out of that downhill. And he wants you to know that his grace and his mercy, it's available for you today. Even today is the day of salvation. He said, harden not your heart, shall we pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we say thank you, Lord, for another opportunity to come before your throne room of grace. We say thank you, O God, for your blood. We say thank you for your word. We say thank you for your Holy Spirit, O God. We say thank you, O Lord, for Jesus Christ, your Son, who came and died for us, O God, who rose from the dead, O God. We say thank you, O God, that Jesus is making intercessions for us, sitting at the right hand of the Father, O God, and he shall come again to judge the living and the dead. Father, O God, we say thank you, O God, that we are passed from darkness into light, O God, through your blood, through salvation, through, O God, Father, Lord God, the obedience of Jesus as he went to the cross for us, O God. Father, we say thank you for salvation on this evening. And tonight, O God, we just want to give you praise, we give you thanks, we give you glory, O God. You're the all-seeing God and the all-knowing God. And even as, O God, we come and we empty ourselves before your presence, we say, O God, Father, Lord God, that Jesus Christ is Lord. We say, O God, Father, Lord God, that we worship and that we adore you. We appreciate you, O God. We bow before you, O God. And Father, O God, tonight, O God, whatever situations are on your people, O God, your blood is able to break every chain. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen and amen. Praise the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ is Lord.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain.
There's power in the name of Jesus. Whatever you're going through this evening, it begins with salvation. Amen. It begins with salvation and it ends with salvation. And God wants to break every chain. Amen. Because there's power in the name of Jesus. We come to the Father through the Son, and Jesus Christ is Lord. There's power in the name of Jesus.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
On your weakest day, there's power in the name of Jesus.
There is power in the name of Jesus. We know where it is to break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Come on, say to break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. There's an
praise the Lord, hallelujah. There's an army rising up. And tonight God wants to you to rise up, to be awakened from your sleep. He's coming again, and he's coming to judge the living and the dead. Whatever is your situation, Jesus Christ is Lord. Tonight the scripture reading is taken from Ezekiel chapter 34, and we're going to read from verse 22, and we are going to go down to verse 27. Praise the Lord. 22-7. The word of the Lord is already blessed. And I always advise that as we read the word of God, that you get a pen, a paper, and take a note and go and search the scripture yourself. Because many false prophets and teachers are gone on, and if it's possible, to deceive the very elect. So make your election sure. Get into the truth of the word of God. Amen. Verse 22 reads as follows. Therefore say unto the house of Israel, thus said the Lord God, I do not this for your sake, O house of Israel, but for my holy name's sake, which ye have profaned among the heathen, whither ye went. And I will sanctify my great name, which was profaned among the heathen. which ye have profaned in the midst of them, and the heathen shall know that I am the Lord, said the Lord God, when I shall be sanctified in you before their eyes. For I will take you from among the heathen, and gather you out of all countries, and will bring you into your own land. Then will I sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean. From all your filthiness, and from all your idols will I cleanse you. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you. And I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you an heart of flesh. And I will put my spirit within you, and cause you to walk in my statutes, and you shall keep my judgment and do them. This is the word of the Lord. I'm just going to read over verse 26 and verse 27 of Ezekiel chapter 36. Praise the name of the Lord. He said, a new heart will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you. And I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you an heart of flesh, and I will put my spirit within you, and cause you to walk in my statutes, and ye shall keep my judgment and do them. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. This is what God wants us to do. He wants us to walk in his ways. Amen. He wants us to walk in his statutes. Amen. Jesus Christ is Lord. And tonight, whatever situation you're going through, know that he's coming again. He wants your heart to be prepared. He wants you to have a new heart and a new spirit. Amen. He wants to take out that stony heart, the heart that is not thinking about him, the heart that don't care about him right now. And he wants to give you salvation. He's coming again to judge the living and the dead. Tonight is your chance for salvation. Jesus Christ is the Lord.
Of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored.
Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Jesus Christ is Lord. Tonight, I just want to say a prayer before we begin our program tonight, speaking about the word of God and bringing the truth of the gospel. Shall we pray? For those who do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, the word of God says, if we confess with our mouths and believe in our heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, he'll come into our hearts and he will live there forever. And for those who are saved, every day we have to work out our salvation with fear and trembling. You might say, okay, I'm saved for a long time. But the word of God says we grow from glory to glory and from strength to strength. He said, work out our salvation with fear and trembling. He said that we must have enduring power. He said, if we endure to the end, then we will be saved. Terrible times are upon this earth. And whether you save or you are not saved, the choice is yours. It's your life. It's your salvation. It's your choice. We are here to present the gospel of Jesus Christ uncompromised. And tonight, for that one who do not know Jesus Christ and as the Lord and Savior, I want to say a special prayer. If you have tuned in tonight, or if you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, that God will show us all the importance of what salvation really means to our lives, and how we can come up higher in him. In Jesus' name shall we pray. Father, again, O God, I come before your throne room of grace, and I ask you, O God, Father, because you said we have not because we ask not. This tonight, O God, I ask you, O God, Father, to save us, O God, and our household in the name of Jesus. You promise, O God, to save us and our household, O God. So, Father, O God, I ask you to save us and our household tonight in the name of Jesus. I ask you, O God, for that one who do not know you as the Lord and Savior, O God, that tonight as this word go forth, O God, and they have tuned in, O God, whether they be in their car, whether they be, O God, in their homes, O God, whether, O God, Father, Lord God, wherever they are, their jobs, wherever, O God, in their bed, O God, I ask you to draw them, not by might, draw that one by your Holy Spirit, O God. Father, we have no power to save anyone, O God, but it's by your grace and by your mercy, O God. I ask you, O God, to draw that one who have tuned in this evening, that they would receive you as Lord and Savior, O God, of their life, O God. I ask you, O God, to translate that one from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light. I ask you, O God, that the light of Christ will shine upon someone this evening, O God, and that we will all come up higher, O God, in a higher place with with you, God. We learn in part and we understand in part, oh God. Help us to truly understand that gift of salvation that you have given to us, oh God. Help us to see, oh God, your word, oh God, Father, Lord God, as how, oh God, you want us to see it, oh God, as the ultimate and only truth, oh God, Father, whereby man can be saved. Oh God, you said no one comes to the Father but by you. So tonight, oh God, I ask your Holy Spirit, oh God, to do something new in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Do something, Lord, for that one who do not know you. Do for us, oh God, what we cannot do for ourselves, that we represent you, oh God, Father, as the Lord of our lives, wherever we go. So it is and so it shall be. Jesus is coming again, amen. And tonight, you know, when we think about salvation and we look at salvation, we know that signs of the times are everywhere, amen. And we want to make sure that we are saved, amen. That we have saved our soul, amen. Sometimes, you know, we go through different situations in life, but without salvation, we come into the life with nothing and we would live with nothing if we did not accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Tonight we're going to talk about salvation. Amen. The name Jesus derived from the Hebrew Joshua itself meaning salvation. Joshua means salvation. Amen. And Jesus came according to Luke 19 verse 10. He came to seek that which was lost. So for you to have salvation, you must recognize that you are lost. Amen. That you are not saved. There's a possibility that you can drown in your sins. Amen. That your sins will lead you to an eternal hell, eternal damnation. Heaven and hell, they are real places. Amen. And Jesus came to save that which was lost. Salvation has a beginning and salvation has an end. Amen. The beginning of salvation is faith. Amen. It begins with faith. The Bible says without faith, it is totally impossible to please God. Who comes to God must believe that God is God, and he rewards those who diligently seek him. Amen. So we must have that faith to know that there is a God who have created you, and he created you for his glory. He created you to have a relationship with him. And because of this connection, Adam and Eve sinned. He had a disconnection with us, and he sent Jesus Christ as our mediator between God and man, so that we can connect to him, the Father, and we can come to him with childlike faith, speak to him, commune with him, talk to him, and he has blessings. He has salvation. He has redemption. He has restoration and all those things that consist of salvation. We are justified by faith. We are made righteous through Christ Jesus. Amen? So salvation has a beginning and an end. It begins with faith. Who comes to God must believe that God is God. We must believe that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. The word of God said if we confess with our mouth and believe in our heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, he will come into our heart. He will live there. Amen. He wants us to invite him in. He said if he comes to your door and he's knocking at your heart, if you open up your heart, he will come in and he will have supper with you. He will sup with you. He will have fellowship with you. He will speak to you. He will embrace you. He will take you in. Amen. He said who comes to him, he will not cast you away. Amen. And tonight you might be struggling with what is life. You look around and you see so many things going around in nations. Amen. There's bombings, there's killings, there is lawlessness, so many evils going around in nations. Amen. But God wants to talk to us as individuals. Amen. He wants to speak to us as nations. He wants to speak to us as families. And we are part of the body of Christ. He wants to speak to the body of Christ. Salvation, it involves the freedom to choose. Amen. As well as a divine election. Amen. God says he knows, he calls us. Amen. And he knows who's going to answer because he's the all-knowing God. He said who he called, he predestined to become after his own image, to become like him. Amen. But he knows because he knows the heart of man. That's why he's God. He knows who's going to accept him and he knows who's going to reject him. Amen. But he has given us a choice. He said, I set before you life and I set before you death. And I'm telling you, I'm making it easy for you. I'm letting you know that the choice that you should make is to choose life. It's your life, it's your salvation, and it's your choice. But he gives us the alternative that if I said those still two things before you, one is good and one is evil, one is right and one is wrong. Amen. One is right, one is wrong. And he's telling us which is the right choice to make. He said, choose life. Amen. So, but also, although salvation involves this freedom of choice, God also has a divine knowledge of who's going to accept him and who is going to reject him. He said, if you deny me in front of men, I'm going to deny you in front of my Father. Amen. Many are called, but few are chosen. And I know God has been calling you on tonight. I know he's been speaking to your spirit man. He's tugging at your spirit man. I know when God tugged at my own spirit to give my life to Christ, I did not come right away. I didn't just come rushing, because man is naturally wicked. Amen. Man has not a desire to please God or to come to God. But unless the Holy Spirit draws us, amen. And sometimes even when the Holy Spirit draw one to him, then sometimes because of we are still in the flesh, we decide, okay, then I'm gonna do it on my own time, my own way. God wants you to do it his way. Amen. Time is drawing nigh. Time is winding down. Amen. No one has tomorrow in their hands but God. And he wants you to know that tonight, if you are hearing this word, he wants you to give your heart, your life to him. Amen. I said before you life and death, and he's saying to you, choose life. God tried to show us the validity, the importance of salvation in many ways throughout the word of God. In the Old Testament he showed, in the New Testament he showed us. Amen. From Genesis to Revelation, it's really all about salvation. It's all about getting to know our God through his son Jesus Christ, accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, so that we can have a relationship with God Almighty, with the power of the Holy Spirit, bringing clarity to what God's word is saying. That's the whole essence of this word in a nutshell. Amen. We see in Genesis chapter 45, Noah, we're looking at some people in the New and the Old Testament. We still talk about the old, really. That if you have your Bibles, you can turn to Genesis, and we're going to read something from verse 45. Praise the name of Jesus. Genesis chapter 45. And we're going to read from verses 4 to 7. Amen. Genesis chapter 45, sorry, and verse 4 to 7. Joseph said on 4 to 7. Okay. Joseph was the one who God had called in Genesis chapter 45. We see the story of Joseph made himself known to his brothers. He sent for his fathers when his brothers had put him into a pit, and he was the one that God has chosen out of all his brothers to bring salvation to Egypt, who was going to experience famine, and also to his kindred, his brothers, his father, and those of his loved ones. Amen. So he became the savior. Noah became also, he was chosen by the savior, by God, during his time to save his house, to end that judgment that God was going to put on the people because of their lawlessness and their evil. Noah was chosen, and his household and his animals were saved because the people did not believe him. They had an opportunity to be saved, but they rejected him. And you see that only his family and the animals, a pair of each animals, they were saved. Amen. Yet still everyone had the opportunity to come into the ark. Amen. And as we look at the ark, it's a foreshadow of the fact that God wants us to come into his ark, come into salvation, come into the kingdom. He wants to move us out of lawlessness, out of the world, and into the kingdom of God. We could be in the world, but he said, be in the world, but not be of the world. Amen. And when he had given man who was lawless the opportunity to come into that safety before this flood came, they rejected. Amen. They must have looked at Noah and said, look at that man, he's so foolish, and how he think that, you know, he's gonna have a flood. No, they did not believe. And so it is with the word of God says, as it was in the day of Noah, so it's gonna be in the end times. In the end times, we see that people are rejecting God. People are not seeing the seriousness of the times that we are living in, and we are taking that salvation for granted. There comes a time when the Holy Spirit would not be tugging at your own spirit, because in Revelation we see that Jezebel was given time to restore, repent, and she did not. In Revelation chapter 2, we see that she did not repent, and he said that then God judgment came upon Jezebel. Amen. So it is that when we do not conform to the things of God and what God has speak to us or into our spirit. If God is speaking to your spirit tonight and you're feeling the Holy Spirit is telling you it's time that I submit myself to the Lord and I accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior, God wants you to do so. He said, if you are willing and if you are obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. You shall receive salvation. Amen. So the people rejected, and guess what? The flood came. Amen. And guess what? They were perishing. They all perished. Amen. God does not want us to be perishing. He does not want us to perish. He does not want us to go to a priceless eternity. He wants that all come to a full repentance. Amen. And how we repent is by turning away from the things that we're doing that does not please God and do the things that he has stipulated in his word. Jesus Christ is Lord. Whether we believe it or not, whether we accept it or we reject it, he's not going to say that he is Lord. He's a holy God. He wants us to know that by his stripes, you know, he went to the cross and we are healed of everything that is negative in our life. We healed financially. We are healed physically. You know, everything that causes us to have a disease or sickness, or behavior, you know, attitude in our concept of thinking, he wants to redirect our heart. Even as we read in Ezekiel tonight, that he wants to give us a heart of flesh. He wants to take away that stony heart and give us a new spirit, which is the Holy Spirit. God wants to change our lives. And it starts with salvation. There's nothing you can do. We can try to, or I should say, change things ourselves. But without the power of the Holy Spirit, our efforts are just things that we are doing, and we might be morally correct, but we're not spiritually correct. Amen. Salvation, the blood of Jesus, is the only thing that could put us in right standing, whereby we can come to a holy God and say, Abba Father. Amen. Abraham was obedient, and he put his son on the altar of sacrifice. He wanted to be obedient to God because God told him to sacrifice his only son. And it came with him being obedient, and then God provided a ram in the bush. Again, it shows us that when man failed and man effort was not enough to make him, to have him do the things that will bring him into fellowship, continual fellowship with God, then Adam sinned, Eve sinned, and he had to bring an advocate, someone to go between, somebody instead, you know, who can come and take that burden and do all the things that he did. He came to heal the sick, raise the dead, set the captive free, to die on a painful cross and be risen from the dead, sitting at the right hand of the Father, making intercessions for us. And he wants us to know tonight that the price that he paid is available to us all. Amen. Now that when we look at Abraham's life, because he was willing to sacrifice his son, just as God was willing to sacrifice his son, Jesus Christ, his only begotten son. And because Jesus was obedient to go and to come down to earth and be that sacrificial lamb, Isaac did not struggle with his father Abraham. He went onto the altar willingly and lay on the altar while everything was prepared for his body to be burnt. He went willingly because he obeyed his father. And isn't that so typical and so in line with what Jesus did? Amen. So God was always trying to show us that salvation is necessary in order for us to bring some redemption to our lives, because you know that gave Abraham an opportunity to be in right standing with God because of his obedience. Amen. God wants us to be obedient to his word so we can be in right standing with him. His word says we must be born again. We must ask him to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us. We must repent, which means we must turn around and stop doing the things that will frustrate God and will make him angry, will make him hurt, will make him turn his back from us. He wants us us to come in right standing with him. And we must be born again, not born of water, just of water, but be born of the Spirit, which means he's going to give us a new heart, a heart of flesh. Because Jesus will take over your life and he will give you a new spirit. Amen. He wants to break every chain. Amen. He wants you to know tonight that whatever situations that you're going through, every chain can be broken because of his blood and because of his word. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because of Abraham's obedience, putting Isaac on that altar of sacrifice, that came with that promise that God had made to Abraham. He promised national blessing to his descendants and to all the families on the earth. Amen. National blessings. Amen. Not just for him, not just for his descendants and his people, his immediate family, but to the whole world. Amen. So Abraham, blessing is yours. You have an opportunity to be saved today because Jesus Christ came as the ultimate sacrifice. Amen. When we look at the word of God, we see Esther, because she was married to the king. Amen. Esther was married to a king, and she came to this powerful king to mediate and to be an intercessor for her people so that they would not be wiped out. Amen. Because of time, we're not going to go into the story of Esther. At another time, we'll go into that story. But Esther was another person in the word of God that God used to come so that she can save her people Israel. She came to a great and mighty king and asked him, please have mercy on my people. Amen. Because there was a mandate that went out so that this Israel would be alienated, they would be dead, they would be killed. But she came and she made that petition to the king, and the king listened because she put herself as an intercessor so that Israel can be saved. Amen. One day we'll go into the story of Esther and see how she redeemed her people because of her boldness and because she went in and go to a king, a mighty king. We have the opportunity to go to a mighty God, God Almighty, because there's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the blood of Jesus. There's power in the word. And he wants to save you this evening. He wants you to know there's power in his name. He wants to break every chain tonight. Whatever it's you going through, know that Jesus Christ is Lord. He wants to save you tonight. Stop procrastinating because time is winding down. Jesus Christ is the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We see Moses even in Exodus. When we look at Exodus from chapter 1 all the way to 12, we see Moses being chosen and to bring the Israelites, which spent something like 430 years in captivity under servitude, doing unprofitable hard labor in Egypt. And Moses was chosen to deliver the Israelites from bondage. Moses obeyed God. He said, I cannot speak. I have an impediment. But God already prepared his heart. Amen. God already knew that Jesus would be obedient. Amen. So all these people that he showed us in the Old Testament that brought salvation, it was a physical salvation, not a spiritual salvation in the sense that they saved them physically from being destroyed by different circumstances. And in Noah's case, it was he was trying to save them from the flood being destroyed, but they did not turn, they did not obey. It was in terms of Isaac, you know, God saved Isaac because he provided a sacrificial lamb. Amen. In terms of Israel, God sent Moses to lead them out of the house of bondage. Amen. So but now when God did with Jesus, he brought him as a spiritual deliverance to his people. He brought spiritual deliverance to his people. Amen. He brought spiritual deliverance to the world. Amen. Because he said, whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have eternal life. Amen. And we want to know that we have eternal life through Jesus Christ. He wants to break every chain tonight. Whatever you're going through, trust Him. Give your life to Him. Jesus Christ is Lord.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There's power in the name of Jesus. Although God does use people to save His people, as we look in the Old Testament, the only person that can save our soul is Jesus Christ. Amen. He used people that He had chosen, who were able and capable, amen, in His sight to save His people in the Old Testament. But when Jesus came, He came to save the spirit man. Amen. He came with redemption, with salvation. As we confess our sins to Him, as we come to Him, He's able to break every chain that holds us. Amen. Satan wants to keep you in bondage. Amen. There was a time when I didn't want to be saved because I look at salvation as a thing that was a whole bunch of man-made rules or rules in the Bible that I could not follow. Amen. That I think in my mind, in my small mind, that I cannot keep up those things. It's not about keeping up appearances or keeping up anything. When you are saved, it's a spiritual birth, amen? You must be born again, amen? It's Jesus coming into your heart and living there forever, knowing that He has translated your soul from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light, amen? His word is spirit and His word is life, amen? And He wants to give us eternal life. It's not about a set of rules that you obey. When you receive salvation, because of that love that you have for God, you want to do everything to please Him. Amen. When you mess up, when we mess up, you know, you feel dirty, you feel that you failed Him, you feel that you fall below the mark. Anything that falls short of God's glory, it is sin. And you know, there was a time when I received Christ as my Savior, I confessed Him, but was I really saved? I was not sure. Amen. And I always trying to get it right. It's only through the power of the Holy Spirit. When you invite the Holy Spirit to help you, then we can stand and say, okay, God, I feel that you have saved me. I know that you have saved me. But it comes by faith. You have to just believe. Amen. At that time, I didn't understand the fullness of my salvation. And many times, as believers even, sometimes we don't understand how salvation works in our lives. Amen. When we have that childlike faith and we abandon ourselves and say, God, I believe that I am saved. I believe that you wrote my name in heaven. I believe that hell shall never be my home. That hell shall never be my internal destiny. That I am, my name is written in heaven. Heaven shall be my home. And you believe that in your heart, that Jesus Christ is Lord over your heart, your life. Every chain that hold you in that kingdom of God darkness will be loose because your faith believes that God is God and He would reward you as you diligently seek Him. He said, work us your salvation with fear and trembling. It is some things that we have to work out in our lives. Amen. He wants to break every chain. Amen. He wants to break the chains that hold you in the kingdom of darkness. Praise the Lord, hallelujah.
I hear the chains falling.
Praise the Lord, hallelujah. I hear the chains falling. Whatever you're going through tonight, whatever is holding you back, that you kind of holding back certain areas of your heart and you will not totally submit your whole heart to the Lord. He said in His word that He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above what you can ask Him and what you can think. You may think you cannot do the things that He has stipulated in His word, but it's not by might, it's not by power, it's only by His spirit. In Psalm 62 verse 2 and verse 6, He said, He God, which is God, God is speaking here, He alone, God, David was speaking concerning God, He said, He alone is my rock and my salvation. Amen. God alone is your rock and your salvation. There is no other name whereby men can be saved. Amen. Time is winding down. He said in verse 6, He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense I shall not be moved. In God is my salvation and my glory. The rock of my strength and my refuge is my God. Your strength, He's your salvation. In God is your salvation. And in God is Jesus Christ. And He is your salvation. Amen? Because Jesus Christ, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, in God is your salvation. Amen? Jesus Christ wants to come into your heart. Amen? And in Jeremiah 33, verse 23, part of this, it's, you know, the part B says, truly is the Lord our God. He is the salvation of Israel. Amen? We are the sheep of His pastures. He is our good shepherd. Amen? And He wants us to lead us. He wants to lead us. He doesn't want us to lead ourselves. Amen? In Deuteronomy 24, verse 18, it said, but thou shalt remember that thou wast a bondsman in Egypt, and the Lord thy God redeemed thee thence. Amen? For those who are saved, you must remember that you were under servitude. Me too. We were serving Satan. We belonged to Satan before salvation. And when Jesus translated us, when we gave our heart to Jesus, into the kingdom of light, amen? We must remember where He brought us from, amen? The Lord thy God, He redeemed us. And to redeem means to buy us back, amen? To purchase us, amen? And we must take that salvation that He gave us as a precious gift that cannot be, there's no equal to that gift of salvation. There's nothing better knowing that God has sent His Son to pay a ransom for you, that He brought you out of the kingdom of darkness and into His marvelous light. Amen. He wants you to be aware that the salvation that He has given you is a precious gift, and we must treasure that gift. Amen. We must serve Him. We must honor Him every day of our lives. Amen. He gave Israel national deliverance from the enemies. And all too, when we look at the New Testament, we saw how God was patient with Israel, always trying to deliver them. Amen. He will set up a king, they will disobey, they will turn and commit spiritual adultery, going and serving other gods, putting other gods before Him, and He will still be merciful. Amen. He used Hosea the prophet to show that he had a covenant relationship with Israel, and that when he gave him a prostitute to be married to, and then things was not going too well, and then he divorced her. He said, no, you got to remarry her. He was showing that He has a covenant relationship even with Israel, that He purposed to save. Amen? And we see that, you know, God is so merciful. He's so long-suffering. He used a prophet Hosea to show Israel the type of covenant that He had with them. And He used His Son, Jesus Christ. He brought Him into this world to show us that the love that He has for mankind, it is unconditional. It's God kind of love, agape love, God kind of love. Only God could give us that kind of love, in spite of and regardless to, He still loves us. Amen. He was very patient with me. He did not turn me away because I did not accept Him when He called me the first time, nor the second or the third time. But when He called me, amen, He already knew that even though when I procrastinated, that my name, that I would say yes. And tonight, my hope, I believe in God for you tonight, that even that you have turned Him away so many times before, that He knows that your name is already written in heaven, that you will say yes tonight, because it's appointed unto man just once to die, and after death is judgment. Amen. Many times, a lot of people who went on into eternity, they never had the opportunity that I had, that I messed up and God still saved me, that I turned Him away and He still thought about me, that I stayed on the outskirts watching and looking and trying to figure out things so long before I finally surrendered to God. I would not advise anybody to do that, because we do not know when God requires our lives. Amen. Require our soul. We can go to bed tonight and not wake up in the morning. I decree and I declare long life until you receive Him as Lord and Savior. And I decree and I declare that tonight is the accepted time, that you will receive Jesus Christ and you will not procrastinate. You'll give Him your heart tonight. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, for the one who do not know you as Lord and Savior, As that one say, yes, Lord, I receive you tonight. I don't want to procrastinate. I do not want to play with my salvation. I do not want to play with my soul. I want to know that my name is written in your book of life. I ask you, Holy Spirit, to come into that heart tonight. And, oh, Lord God, I ask you to write that name in heaven. That angel will rejoice. I believe by faith that even before this message is finished, oh, God, that this word is, oh, God, complete, that someone has said, yes, Jesus Christ, I accept you as my Lord and Savior. And I say thank you, God, for that one who have responded to your call by the power of your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. There's no God like Jehovah. He's merciful. He's long-suffering. He's patient. And he's waiting for you to say yes. For you who did not receive him tonight, because you still think you have a lot of time. There's no God like Jehovah. Time is winding down. He's coming. And tonight, for someone tonight who has given their life to Christ, but you don't feel that you are connected to God, amen? There was times in my own life when there's times when I felt so far from God. God is always there, amen? He's ever present. He's the omnipresent God. But it's not about a feeling. There was times in my life when I did not feel that God was there. I felt alone, that where is God in my situations? I had some tough things that I had to deal with in my life. And there was no one there. And it seemed like everyone had deserted me. And everyone had moved away from me. And I did not feel that God was there either. But God wants you to know tonight, as he spoke into my spirit during those times, I will never leave you and I will never forsake you. Amen. In Psalm 51, David was crying out to God. And he said in verse 11, cast me not away from thy presence and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of my salvation and uphold me with thy free spirit. Amen. God wants you to know tonight, it's not about a feeling. David was saying, cast me not away from thy presence. I was crying out to God at a particular time in my life. So many different times I would say in my life. When I say, God, do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Because I didn't feel that God was there. You tonight, you might say, I have given my life to Christ and I don't feel that God is there. It's not about a feeling. He said he will never leave you and he will never forsake you. I don't know who I'm speaking you to tonight. But whatever you're going through, God said in his word. And his word is yea, nay, and amen. His word shall not return unto him empty. He's saying to someone tonight that remember the former things that he have done for you before. Amen. And he said the bad ones that he did not, that he doesn't want you to remember. He wants you to look unto the hills from whence cometh your help. He wants you to know the former things that you went through. Look at the day that is coming tomorrow. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. He wants you to know that as you come to him, he knows your name. He knows your address. He knows your situation. David was saying, restore unto me the joy of my salvation. Ask God to restore the joy of his salvation. Amen. Ask him to give you back your joy, because the joy of the Lord is your strength. Amen. Start worshiping the Lord. Start singing to him. Start giving him praise. Remember him in everything that you do. Put him first place in your life again, and everything else shall be added on to you. Amen. Amen. In Psalm 116. Amen. Well, Psalm 116, if you have your Bibles. Psalm 116. And we're going to read from verse 13. Praise the Lord. It said, I will take the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. You feel so distant from the Lord, but take the cup of salvation. Amen. It is not an empty cup. It's a cup that is full. Amen. That your joy will be full. Take the cup of salvation. It's a cup that has redemption, that has forgiveness, that have mercy, that have God's goodness, that have his kindness, that has so much things, his righteousness. Amen. It has his grace. Amen. Grace, power to operate in areas that you have no power of your own. Amen. And favor that you do not merit, that you didn't have to do anything for. He has an open heaven in his cup over your head. Amen. There's so much things in salvation. He has his blood. He has the word which will come alive to you by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. It's a cup of salvation. Amen. So many things in this salvation that God wants to give to you. And tonight, whatever is your situation, you do not know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Still, you have heard that salvation cry tonight, and you're still saying, I don't know if this is what I want. The Word of God is a lamp unto our feet and a light to our path. Amen. In the book of Isaiah, amen, as we look at this last scripture, Isaiah chapter 62. We see the word of God says here in Isaiah 62 and verse 1. It says, for Zion's sake, I will not hold my peace for the journey. Praise the Lord. In Isaiah 62, praise the Lord, verse 1. It says, for Zion's sake will I not hold my peace, and for Jerusalem's sake I will not rest until the righteousness thereof go forth as brightness, and the salvation thereof as a lamp that burneth. Amen. And salvation as the lamp that burneth. Amen. That salvation is like a torch. Amen. It's like a lamp. Amen. And God wants to shine his light on you tonight. Amen. He wants you to receive him. So we pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, I seal all these words concerning salvation. It shall not return unto you void. I seal, oh God, this message in your blood, oh God, that someone have received you as Lord and Savior tonight. For someone, oh God, who the joy of the Lord have been sapped out because of the plans of the enemy, I decree and I declare, oh God, that Jesus Christ is Lord. I decree and I declare, oh God, Father, that tonight that they will take up that torch of their salvation, that, oh Lord God, Father, their joy will be full, oh God, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, that they will take the cup of thanksgiving, oh God, the cup of their salvation, and examine how many things that you have done for, oh God, your daughter or your son tonight, oh God. I ask you, oh God, Father, to be, oh God, our shepherd. I ask you, oh God, Father, through your son Jesus, oh God, through the power of the Holy Spirit, that we may know you. And the power, oh God, that you have given Jesus through his resurrection, oh God. I thank you, oh God, for that one, oh God, who have said, yes, Jesus Christ is Lord. And that one, oh God, who has said, I will come higher with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, Lord God, I thank you, oh God, that every chain that hold your people under bondage tonight, oh God, I decree, oh God, it's broken by the power in the name of Jesus. And we say thank you for doing it. So it is, and so it shall be. Jesus Christ is Lord. This is Evangelist Jennifer Pope coming to you from Choice Gospel Radio, 92.9 FM. Your life, it's your salvation, and it's your choice. Jesus Christ is Lord. This is not going to change. Make him your Lord and Savior before it's too late. Praise the Lord. Amen and amen.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every